In this video, we want to demonstrate the drawing of a trend channel, a narrow sideways channel, as well as the N% or 50% ruler within Track and Trade. I'm doing this demonstration in the stocks version of Track and Trade, but these features are exactly the same whether using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. So the first thing we want to demonstrate is a trend channel tool. You notice the trend channel tool is this icon here. We go ahead and click it, and when we click it, if we have the preferences tab selected, you'll notice that the preferences for this particular tool appear. To draw a trend channel tool, we simply start at the top of the upper level of the trend. We left click, we move our cursor to the lower level of the trend, we left click once again. This gives us the trend line that we're looking for. We draw the trend line up the trend. We click once again. This then allows us to bring the upper level of the channel up into the location that we desire, which highlights the trend itself. And a final left click will release the mouse and have our trend line drawn for us. You'll notice that we can then come back and grab any of the handles and move them for a fine adjustment to replace them anywhere we would like. You'll also notice that this trend channel has a handle in the middle of the trend bar, and so you can come in and grab those and move those. It's kind of like a window shade and allows you to move those up and down and move those with the trend. So that's how you use the trend channel. If we come over here to the right preferences window, you'll notice that we have the functionality of being able to change the colors. Maybe we want to change it to a different color, a different line style or thickness. We also have the ability to change the background color and the ability to snap it to individual price bars. To remove the trend channel, all we do is simply, if it's highlighted, we can either hit the delete key on our keyboard, or we can right click and hit delete on the right click menu. The next tool that I want to draw for you is the narrow sideways channel tool. The narrow sideways channel tool is selected by clicking the narrow sideways or horizontal channel tool within the button bar. Again, you'll notice if you have the preferences tab selected that this brings up the preferences for this particular tool. We then draw the narrow sideways channel by simply left clicking and holding down the mouse button and drawing across the channel itself like this, highlighting the upper region or the resistance area against the support region on the bottom. Releasing the mouse button gives us that confirmation that that box is done, and then we can stretch it and make it longer or shorter by grabbing the different handles. We can make it taller or narrower by grabbing the middle handles. We also, if we come over here to the control panel, have the additional controls as well. We can come in and we can change the colors, we can change the line styles, we can change the line thickness, we can change the background color, we can change the font sizes, make it bold, different fonts, whatever we would like to do in this box here. We also have the ability to show the text or turn the text off and have it snap to individual price bars when we lay the tool in. So this is a way of using the narrow sideways channel tool within Track and Trade. And to remove it from the screen, we can very simply just right click over the top of it and hit the delete key, or you can always hit the delete key on your keyboard. The next tool that I want to draw for you is the N% tool, or what we call the 50% ruler. It's listed here. We go ahead and we click that icon, and the N% tool is designed to help us identify the retracement level of a 50% move of overall move in the market. So we draw it by starting at the top of the trend and just dragging down over through the center of the trend and all the way to the bottom of the trend, identifying the area of support on the top and resistance on the bottom. You'll notice that the center line is right at 50%. We can grab the handles and change the adjustment or change the size of the box that is representative of the trend itself. And you'll notice the reason we call it the N% tool is because we can grab this handle in the center and we can move it up and down, and it tells us the different levels, varying levels based on where we move this to. So it's not just a 50% tool, but it can tell us how far back this market moved against itself, one versus the other, and do the different calculations. Depending on which way you draw the tool, whether you draw it from the top to the bottom, will determine which direction the market is calculating the retracement. So you'll notice in this case, as we slide it up here, this would say that this is a 21% pullback. If we draw it from the bottom to the top, let's redraw it. We'll draw it from the bottom to the top of the trend, and we can bring it in here. You'll notice that as we bring this up, this would then say that this is a 79% retracement level. So depending on which way you want to calculate, you can draw the tool from the top to the bottom or from the bottom to the top, depending on which way you would like to calculate. Again, if we come over to the Preferences tab, we can change the color of the tool, we can change the line style, we can change the thickness of the lines, we can also change the background color, we can change the font size, we can also make those bold, we can show the text or not, and of course we can snap to the individual price bars themselves. If you want to get rid of it, just like any other tool, we can right click on it and hit delete, or we can, as long as have the handle selected, we can hit the delete key on the keyboard and it will delete it and remove it from the chart.